This lecture is over mediated communication. I will discuss several elements revolving around this topic. I will tell you what is mediated communication, the types of mediated communication, some examples, and some effects that it may have. By the end of this mini lecture, I hope you will have a good understanding over the topic mediated communication. Mediated communication is any type of communication that occurs using electronic means. There are two types. There's mass communication and computer-mediated communication, otherwise known as CMC. Mass communication occurs when professional communicators use technology like the radio or television to share messages to large audiences. Computer-mediated communication occurs when a human-to-human interaction is taking place through networked computers. Some mass communication examples include newspapers, television, the internet, and even magazines. Now, these examples can have some drawbacks and some benefits. As a consumer, it is your responsibility to have the knowledge of these different types of mass medias. That way, you can effectively consume the messages and information being processed. Mass media can have its effects. On people, it can certainly change the behaviors that they wish to be involved in. Mass media is also very powerful that it has the potential to shape culture, either by acting as a gatekeeper for information, by setting the agenda of current issues and problems, also cultivating perceptions and even stereotypes. Again, mass media can have either its benefits or drawbacks. The next element I will speak about is computer-mediated communication. The examples range from electronic mail, such as your Yahoo and Gmail account, bulletin board systems, such as a student discussion board on an online class, instant messaging, chat rooms, audio-video conferencing, such as Skype or even FaceTime on a smartphone, also social networking sites, such as Facebook and Twitter, and blogs. There are two types of computer-mediated communication. Various forms of this type of communication will fall into one of these categories, synchronous communication or asynchronous communication. Synchronous communication occurs when members are able to interact with each other in real time. Also, as they communicate, each participant will follow one after another as the receiver and senders of messages. Asynchronous communication occurs when the communication interaction is delayed and participants must take turns being the sender and receiver of the messages. So an example would be an email message. You would email the receiver as you are the sender, and once they receive your message, then they will send you one back and you will become the receiver. But that might not be automatically. There's going to be a pause between your messages. An example for synchronous communication would be an audio-video conference call through Skype. You guys are in real time, communicating with each other, so there'll be no pauses between your messages. After a brief commercial break, I will discuss the last element we have to talk about over our mediated communication lecture. I will discuss how computer-mediated communication has an effect on the communication process, and our lecture will be completed. Please enjoy this commercial.
Did you know autism now affects 1 in 88 children? More children will be diagnosed with autism this year than with AIDS, diabetes, and cancer combined. Autism is the fastest growing serious developmental disability in the United States. It receives less than 5% of the research funding of many less prevalent childhood diseases. There is no medical detection or cure for autism. Autism Speaks is a nonprofit organization which believes it is your time to listen. Visit autismspeaks.org to become educated on autism and learn ways you can give to autism. You can attend walks, volunteer for events, and donate money. Autism Speaks. It's time to listen.
Welcome back. Now to discuss our last element. Computer-mediated communication affects the communication process in several ways. In order for it to be used effectively, users must adapt to the environment and the type of communication that is taking place. It's not face-to-face communication anymore. Now we're communicating through technology and computers. Computer-mediated communication can have some positive and negative effects. For example, it can be used to create virtual communities or it can also cause social problems. Regardless, this type of communication is very effective in allowing people to discuss their opinions, express their ideas, thoughts, and even speak about issues or topics according to their interests. This concludes the lecture over mediated communication. You must remember, to become an effective consumer of these type of messages, you must understand how to critically evaluate the messages, you must learn how to use the technology and media, and most importantly, how to become an effective listener. It is very easy for you to become distracted or not pay attention during mediated communication, such as this lecture. But hopefully you did pay attention and now you have a good understanding over our topic, mediated communication.